Before we begin our awards announcements, we have a special guest with us today, a past participant and winner of our Concours d'Oratoire. I would like to introduce Anna Godet. Anna Godet is an honors student at Dalhousie University, completing a combined degree in sustainability and history. In 2017, Anna placed second at the National Concours d'Oratoire in Ottawa for her speech on time travel. Since the Concours, Anna has gone on to work at the Canadian Museum of Immigration at Pier 21, the Halifax Citadel, as well as George's Island, completing guided site tours, which has allowed her to continue to practice her public speaking skills in both languages. Anna, I invite you to take the mic.
Okay, thank you so much. Bienvenue tout le monde. Pour commencer, je vais poser une question. Que pensez-vous de la voyage dans le temps? Now, that might seem like a weird introduction, but that was my first sentence of my 2017 Concours speech. Those first few lines, I practiced them in the mirror and in the shower so many times that I think they're permanently in my brain at this point. Sometimes I like to try to challenge myself to see how far into the speech I can remember. And while it differs, I'll never in my life forget that first line and what it would mean to me. So as was mentioned, my name is Anna Godet. I'm here to tell you folks a little bit about my experience with the Concours and Canadian Parents for French. So like everyone who has participated in the competition up to this point, my introduction started in one of my classrooms, and it started with a very enthusiastic French teacher I had named Madame Nazarian. Madame Nazarian was my teacher for French in grade 11, way back in 2017, feels like a long time ago now, based on where we are in this current situation. But that year I chose to write my speech on time travel and some of the implications that came with it. I'll say right away that time travel paradoxes are not the easiest to explain in your second language, but I was excited to say Le Back to the Future in a French accent. So for a few weeks on end, Madame Nazarian and I, we spent our lunch hours together. We practiced pronunciation, we chatted about our favorite movies on the topic, all in preparation for the big weekend. So prior to grade 11, I hadn't heard much of anything about the Concours or what it meant. I went to a rural junior high school. I started French in grade 7. I do come from an Acadian family. We lost our French generation before mine, so my involvement in French activities was limited to what my teachers could supply. But from that frustrating first week of French immersion, I was very excited to keep learning and exploring how to communicate in this language, as nonsensical as something like Pleu que parfait might seem. So, when it came time for the Nova Scotia Provincial Concours at Mount St. Vincent, I was so excited. I can honestly close my eyes and I still remember the atmosphere of pure anxiety, but also this really overwhelming sense of community that was there that weekend. We all gathered for the same reason. We were passionate speakers. And once the ceremony began, it was clear that the competitive aspect of the Concours was really the least important part of the weekend. I was lucky enough to place first in my category, one that was filled with impressive candidates. They talked about a wide range of topics. My placement meant I had the opportunity to travel to Ottawa for the national competition. In addition to receiving a generous scholarship from the Université de Sainte-Anne. I was really shocked when my name was called, and I was just so excited about this opportunity that was being provided. So when I went to Ottawa, it was my first time on a plane. I nervously fidgeted through the security line. I was scared I wasn't doing it right. But again, I was so excited because this was a new life experience that I was having. And while I know this experience isn't one that some of you will have, it looks different this year. One thing that I can say with absolute confidence is that incredible new life experiences are coming your way because of your participation here today. So once I arrived in Ottawa, I met my hotel roommate. She was actually a girl who lived 20 minutes away from me that I had never met before. Her name was Annie, and we became great friends over the course of just a few short hours. Along with a few other contestants from the Maritimes, I remember we all laid in the comfy beds together. We took turn practicing our speeches all night. We would applaud each other so loud that the room next door of contestants came over and joined in on our little practice concours that we had started. And by that first night, I knew that all these people, they were just as happy as I was to be here and share our love of speaking and of French. And that really outshadowed any sort of competitive aversion that we might have to each other. The 2017 national contestants and I still maintain a group chat to this day. And it's been so fun to watch each other grow from all corners of the country, and very fun to say I have friends from the Northwest Territories. So at the national competition, I once again presented my speech on time travel. It was very fun to see new faces grapple with the questions I was posing, and I enjoyed watching the performances of my peers even more so. I got to learn about theater, bees, life in small town Nunavut, the possibilities that come with artificial intelligence. At this stage in the competition, I placed second, which was of course very exciting, but even more so exciting was the evening of exploring this new city with some new friends I had made. Since the concours, I have continued to follow this passion and confidence in public speaking. I currently hold a supervisory position for visitor services of the Halifax Citadel and George's Island, which has really allowed me to use my French every single day. Not in the past season, but before that, of course. I loved that feeling when someone would walk up to the kiosk to speak with me. They'd come off a cruise ship, maybe from France or from Belgium. I would hear them start to discuss how to purchase the ticket in French, and I would pipe up with a little, "Je parle français si ça c'est mieux," and I'll just never get tired of those like excited squeals of relief that people have when you're able to communicate with them in their language. I particularly recall my experience as a French tour guide when I worked at the Canadian Museum of Immigration. I had this lovely French woman who was on one of my tours. She was the daughter of a war bride who had come to Canada from France with her infant child when she was only 20 years old, which was the age I was at the time I was giving the tour. This woman and I, we sat together in our little model colonist train car, just like the one her mother would have ridden in. And we had this nice moment of reflection and conversation about history and family. And in that moment, I just remember really feeling privileged that I was able to share this with her. And I wouldn't have had that opportunity if I didn't learn French and I didn't gain confidence in my ability in French. And those are both connections that I don't think I would have been able to have without the concours. And I know that this is just my experience and my own story, but I'm so excited over all of the great things that I know each and every one of you are going to do and the people you're going to become. Even if this seems like a kind of a minute event or another line on your resume, the confidence that this type of work provides you with is something that will benefit you from this point onward. You know, remember why you're all here. You're very talented, bright, passionate individuals. You worked very hard to make it to this point. Oral exams and French presentations are not easy. Everybody knows that. So I extend my sincerest congratulations to everyone. And I'm so happy that the concours was able to happen virtually this year. So everyone, take the biggest deep breath you can. Give yourself a big old pat on the back. You just finished this exceptional experience in your second language. And thank you so much for allowing me the chance to chat about my experience. I extend everyone a big virtual hug, and I cross my fingers that the next time I can return as a judge or an MC that we can all be together in person again. So thank you very much.
Merci beaucoup, Anna. C'était tellement bien expliqué.